I'm going to take a moment to get this repository onto my computer. First, I'll make a directory called todo. I'll cd into it, and I'm going to say git init. That'll make an empty git repository. I'm also going to say git poll and this URL here. Once that's done, I should be able to say git log, and sure enough, there are all of the commits, and they're the same commits that are here on GitHub. I'm going to hop back to my terminal, type q to get out of that, and also, if I happen to pull it up in my Finder here, you'll find that indeed we do have a todo application right here. Now, one of the very first things I do when I get a new project is I run it in the browser. Now, sometimes this means setting up a local server or installing this or that, and all those instructions are usually in the README. In this application, you can see there is no README. And because this case is fairly simple, we can actually just run it directly, literally by clicking and dragging index.html here into the browser. If you have a local server set up already on your computer, go ahead and use that. And if you want to explore local servers and learn how to get them set up, check out the link in the instructor notes. We're going to move on right now. In this case, we can see we're looking at a to-do application. This is really convenient because we need to make a list of things to do. Here's some good things to do when you first get a code base. First, I always run the application to see how it works. Then I like to explore the file structure and see what I can infer about the code organization. It's also important to look at what JavaScript files are being loaded. Sometimes people will use module loaders, which is just a fancy way of saying a library that loads other libraries in the correct order. In this case, we don't have any complex stuff going on. Things are staying simple. So we can just look in the bottom of the index.html file to see what JavaScript files are being loaded. It's also super important to spend some time figuring out what all these libraries actually do. You probably already know what jQuery does, but what about the other libraries that are being loaded? Now, these are four of the key things that I like to do when I'm first exploring a code base. Now, we've already run the application. In fact, I just did. I'm running it right now. It's very convenient that it's a to-do application. Take a few minutes right now to explore the file structure, look at what JavaScript files are loaded, and figure out what those libraries do. Sometimes that means looking at their code, but most of the time it means Googling for them and seeing what their homepage says.